Hi.
Hello.
Welcome.
To Legend of Zelda, Phantom Hourglass. It's been a hot minute since we last played this game, and my memory is gone. But trying my best. This is the 12th game in this series so far out of 36. We've been slowly making our way throughout the franchise, but you don't need to not have the knowledge of all of the games to understand this game story. All you really need is the last one. The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker ended with the Princess Zelda, who is disguised as a character named Tetra, and the legendary hero Link riding away on a ship to find the new Hyrule, to find new lands to settle on and create a new version of Hyrule. In that process, along the way, they came upon a ghost ship where Tetra basically went aboard and got sucked into what looked like a black hole. Link chased after her but passed out and washed ashore on a mysterious island. Now, with the help of a flower named Ciela, I think, and a pirate, like a sailor, named Lineback, we are on a journey to find the ghost ship and save Tetra. To find the ghost ship, we basically need to go into some temples and collect fairies that represent the Triforce, so power, courage, wisdom, and bring those, is it Lineback or Lineback? What's his fucking name? It's Linebacker. So we have these fairies, and we have to bring them to a temple and combine them to make a to allow us to get in. Oh my god, we're collecting these fairies to get into a temple so that we can find the ghost ship and then save Tetra. Jesus Christ. Okay, that's what's going on. That's what's happening. Okay. So, along the way, we're also getting a bunch of loot and doing pirate stuff. Jeez! Okay, let's get started. God damn! Jeez! Okay. I didn't mean to do that. We just finished doing this temple, right here. But it ended with, a fairy appearing that looks just like Ciela. And everybody was like, oh, this is weird. Ooh, this is crazy and weird. But we didn't really figure out why. But now we need to go back to the Temple of the Sea King in order to figure out why things are weird, I guess. And then maybe find the Sea King. Or rather, the ghost ship. Through the Sea King. Through the Sea King with the seamen. We just left the temple.
Oh, jeez.
Mommy? Sorry.
We got Maya. Only two planets left. Pick these bots. Good. I haven't been able to help much with this one because I've been writing.
Special delivery! This is a letter from Romanos to Melinda Island. Ahem. Here's what it says. Hello, my friend. How are you? I've recently found my way to an exciting new calling, but I can't find the right words to explain it in a letter. So the next time you have a chance, stop by. You won't regret it. And here's a grand opening to you. Hang on to it. Romanos. Tourist prow ship part. Go to the shipyard and customize your ship. And that's the end of it. Got all that, sir? And I'm out of here. I need help. What was the Romanos? I don't remember what this is. Hey, Knives, how you doing? Oh, never mind. Shut up.
Oh my god.
What are you doing here, Grandpa?
I came here to tell you something very important.
Oh, nothing important?
Yes, young one. Now listen to what I have. Ciela, you are no ordinary fairy. Among fairies, you are very special. You are a spirit.
Spirit? What are you saying? I mean, I don't have any special powers. There's no way.
I understand how you feel. You lost your memory. Spirit, you just freehold the powers you lost. It's time for you to return to your original form. Please bring me the spirit, Doink. Now I will begin.
Transformed into piss!
How do you feel?
I don't feel any different, but at the same time, everything is different. I feel alive!
I don't remember there.
You're back! You've been waiting for this moment!
Now you can join powers with us.
Your feelings and focus with the other spirits.
Focus deeply. Blind. Help me.
Chad, your ability to sense evil is one of your spirit powers. You've awakened as the spirit of courage. You may not feel all of your true power yet, but someday no evil will be able to hide from you.
Spoink! Come on! I'll show you the way to the ghost ship! I can feel it out there. Let's go!
reason she's not green is because she would blend into the backgrounds.
Yes, yes. Use your hurry, Sploink. Head straight to the ghost ship. Old man. Who are you, really? I will explain when the time is right. Now you must hurry to the ghost ship. Fine, keep your secrets, your sea pickle. I'm just in this for the loot anyways. Hey kid, I just remembered something brilliant. When we were chasing that ghost ship, remember how it vanished into the fog? I'll bet that ghost ship is hiding in the fog. Clear course for the soupiest fog you can find, Lord.
Nah.
It's just boat.
I can...
Huh? You feel strange? I feel something creepy. Very tingle in my spine. Anything weird, Sploink?
Stop right there!
Oh, it's a Gerudo? Shit,
Stop right there! I finally found you, Linebeck!
Maybe? She's using, like, a scimitar.
Oh, no! It's her, Jolene! She's crazy! She's crazier than a rabid squid. Way back when Jolene and I were kids... forget it. Not time for that story. Not when Jolene is gunning for our ship. Always run from Jolene. Set a course away, anywhere far from here. Go! Away! She'll shoot torpedoes at us. Make the ship leap over them before they hit.
The low voice is better Gerudo voice? I don't even remember what voice I gave the Gerudo long ago. Oh, shit.
Ambush.
Do I have to fight them now? I don't know. Fucking, okay, you want, like, a low voice?
Fiend, it's been 100 years since our paths last crossed. Oh, what? You aren't the Linebeck. Little boy in green. Tell me the whereabouts of Linebeck this instant. Keeping it a secret, are we? Playing Jolene for a fool is an unwise choice. You truly don't want to tell. I see. Well then, you will be punished.
I was thinking that too. Jolene, 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 Jolene! Aw, but I was hitting you.
Ooh, I'm more rubber.
Fisted by a little boy in green.
Linebeck, hear my words. Your pet is most skilled.
Before I leave, I have but one thing to say. You.
You! Don't think you've won just because of this battle. Hear me!
Can I use it?
Actually, get one of these every now and then is great for the back. Consider this a tip for getting rid of that crazy woman, Sploink. It's all yours. Nice.
Okay, we're shipping out of here, Sproink. Let's put these waters behind us.
Now hang on. I need to open my winder. Yeah, no, that was a pretty shitty reward for that, but it's... How you doing, Floof? Wanna board this ship? Yes. What is this? Oh, it's this guy. You're suggesting that I can do the mermaid now? I didn't know that I could do it yet. Well, if you can, I could be incorrect. I figured I needed a item. It could be a fool. Well, we know that, but that doesn't have to do with this. Jolene. That's good right there.
Overslept.
I know I gave him a voice before, but I don't remember what it is.
Oh, yeah, I've been feeling pretty generous. I'm picking things up for you, yeah. Here, I got this nice piece of flotsam. More to come, be ready.
Oh, thanks. I don't know what flotsam is.
One more.
I mean, I'll go check it out.
Oh, I don't have any more. I imagine that's enough to make you happy, right? Yeah. There isn't a person alive who isn't happy to get a present.
Don't give him that voice. Too late. You wanna know? Let me go take a look. Let me go check a look. I thought this was the symbol. Yeah. What do you mean? That's the symbol. Me. You tiny? I tried making it big. Me, man. What's the symbol? This. See? It's an N. Oh my god. Hey, Eggs, how are you? Once again, we're dealing with a situation where we had to load the fucking game at some point, and in turn, it erased this progress. I don't see a yellow frog here, therefore, I haven't actually seen this symbol in the game, so according to the game, I'm not allowed to teleport there, even though I know the symbol. Alright.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. More mail.
Special delivery! Oh, thanks, Ebola, for the 39 months. I hope you enjoy your emotes and your balloons. Here's a letter from Jolene. 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 Jolene! How much should we do, say? To my baby sister, Joanne. Many years have passed since we've seen each other. Are you well? I'm sure that you've endured heartache at the hands of some awful man. Well, don't worry about me. I'm fine. As you can tell, I'm just as feisty as ever. You're the only sister I would have in this world. We really should catch up. But I have to ask, are you, you know, do you still have that weird mermaid costume obsession? I think it's fine to dress up as a mermaid and have a little fun now and then, but don't wind up in some old fisherman's net, okay? Your sis, the Shea Pirate, Jolene. So it says, it seems that one wasn't for you after all, Splunk. It seems I may have, broken a federal crime. Talk it up to fate, would you? Do me a favor and deliver that to Joanne, would you? You might be happy if you delivered it to her. For now, you can check it in the collection screen. We'll wait for people to meet and greet you. Okay, I'm off. Please don't tell the police officer. Wow, he's really bad at his job. Job. Okay, so it's not an equipable. Also, hi, Vertigo. How are you?
Mermaid. She's a sly, elusive creature. She will not show herself if monsters lurk nearby. If you see one, you gotta get her attention. Show off your wayfaring art.
Okay. Yeah, so the reason why Ciela isn't green is because 90% of the game, she has to mark where your stylus is, right? So, like, she has to mark where you're going. So she couldn't be green like Courage is because she would blend into the grass. So they had to make her like this weird piss white, so that you wouldn't blend in. This weird piss stained white. Wait, I have a letter for you. Nanan Island. I have got a letter. I have got a letter. I have got a letter. For you, for you, for you. How do I... Oh, I don't want to do that.
Problem. I like getting dressed up as a mythical creature. I'm a human being. Treat me like one. I'm not some freak you can throw stuff at. Just stand there. Just don't just stand there staring at me. Apologize. I'm sorry. Huh. Okay, as long as you understand now that you can't go doing that. Maybe I'm wearing my Mergirl costume, but I'm still me. And isn't this swimsuit cute? I made it myself. No way! You're saying there's an old wayfarer who thinks I'm a real mermaid? Wow, well, that's not my problem, you know? Being awesome. I've always thought that wayfaring towns were neat. I'm in a high seas adventure kind of way. Maybe we're fated to meet. I'm gonna go to that old man's hut and visit him. I hope he raves on and on about the romance of the sea. Thank you.
So, what I'm hearing is he's gonna cheat on his wife. Okay.
Young man, have you found her, the mermaid?
Yeah.
What? My wayfaring heart is filled with the thrill of romance and adventure. You found the mermaid, and she enjoys listening to old wayfarer tales. And she said she would come visit me one day. I'm a fool to believe such a wild tale. How can you toy with the hopes of my romantic wayfaring heart? I've been waiting here, but no mermaid's found the tales of wayfaring to come. Or could it be, must have met another old wayfarer to enchant it with a mermaid song.
Hey, did you hear, Spark? Another older man? You think he's talking about the lazy old guy who drives our ship?
Thank you for spelling it out for me.
Hey kid, can I talk to you for a second? Get this. A little while ago, this girl came up and started talking to me. She had really tan skin and she was really spirited, I'd say. Saucy. And...
Wahoo!
But the thing is, I think she might have something, I think she might have thought I was someone else. I only had the chance to say, hey there, hello, and then she disappeared. And, you know, the life of a dashing sea captain isn't always easy.
Maybe she went back over here now? He already abandoned his family? True.
Oh, it's you. I found this old wayfarer, all thanks to you. He's great. Always raving about the romance of the sea and call of adventure. I'm going to pretend to be a mermaid for a bit and let him think I'm the real thing. Our little secret.
Okay, cool, but I have this letter.
Hey, what have you got there? Come on, you can show me.
Show her the letter?
Yeah. Oh. The letter from Jolene, my big sister. Aw, you came here just to deliver it to me? Thank you so much! I have to tear into it and read it right now. I love letters. Oh, Jolene. She never changes. She's still dressing up as a pirate. I'm glad she's happy with her hobby. Oh, but enough about my sister and her obsession with pirate costumes. I should give you something to thank you for delivering this to me. Here you go.
Nice.
It's okay. I don't need it. Go on, it's yours.
Ha! I finally met the mermaid of my dreams. Never would I have dreamed that the mermaid would come to me. Put a hand in this, young man. So I want to give you this.
Boy.
I had that fishing rod made so that I could hook the mythical mermaid, but obviously don't need it anymore, so you can have it.
Oh, but, I have quite the challenges through the fire of adventure in your heart. You must set the sea, you must sail the seas, fishing for mighty catches like I did in my youth. And while at sea, keep an eye out for fish shadows. Go to where the fish are and, go to where the fish are. When you are above them, tap fish from the menu. And that's when the true romance of the sea will grip you.
Man, I, am not excited about that. Oh golly, am I not excited about this information. Giving up on Stardew forever, it's for the best. Only those with the power to shatter rock will find a path to a new game. Maybe this is the cave you were thinking about earlier, Quack. Hey, Drew, you could do the mermaid quest? Yeah.
So, are you going to play over? It's 20 rupees for a game for kids. Be or none?
Sure.
Yeah, okay, let's... Ah, this is a game of skill. Takes place on the vast stage of the open sea. Leap on board. Prepare to set sail and raise anchor. On the horizon looms a blue target. Man the cannon, take aim, and kaboom! You splash and kaboom! You obliterate the target, ending 100 points! Suddenly, a red target sails into view. It fears nothing, for it cannot be broken. Every time you pound it with cannon fire, you earn 20 points! Bullet pow! So did you get all that or what?
Yeah.
The record is 2,500 points. So good luck with all that,
I love how this guy seems like he hates his job, but he has this set up so well for kids.
Yeah.
The ship sails on its own.
The ship sails on its own. And we're off!
There isn't any to my right because I'm definitely not looking that way. Missing the 1,000 point sign? Oh. That one. definitely could have did better music for this.
And hold day.
And I got almost 2,000. Was there actually a 1,000-point sign, or are you lying?
Well, looks like you got 1920 by 1080 points. You still get the prize. Pick a treasure chest and claim it.
Left. I'm lying? Okay. I just need to get good.
Okay. These 20 rupees a game for kids. Want to play?
I got this. I got this. Everyone. Man, I'm already doing worse. Is there like a combo that I'm not understanding? Like if I hit multiple 20s in a row without missing, am I getting more? Itself. Alright. I got this. I got it! Let's go!
What? 260 points? That's a native! You get the prize for canon excellence. Pick a prize and claim it.
Do I have to do that? Three more times?
Oh, yeah. You beat your record. Way to go or whatever. You qualify for a bonus prize, thank you.
Do I have to do that three more times?
Okay, it's 20 rupees pick.
Do I have to do that three more times? I don't want to do, I have to do that again. I don't know how the upgrades work in this game. I don't know how it works. Anyways, by the way, folks, I was in the middle of a game and also talking to Croissant about her leg stuff. If any of you aren't following, Darth Squirrely, Squirrely, I can't give Squirrely another shout-out, okay, Squirrely's been around for a long time at this point, and they play a lot of story-based games like us, and they're a Star Wars fan, which is dear to my heart, and, they're a cute little VTuber squirrel lady, go follow Squirrely for some good times, maybe they're a friend of the channel, so if you don't follow Squirrely, I will hunt you down. Thank you. anyways, I don't know if I need to do this again. I will, but I don't know if I need to. Let's do it one more time and see what we get. But there was three prizes at the end, so I don't know if I need to do it again. Okay.
The prize for cat and excellent speaker, Jason, claim it.
Got a rock wheel ship part. Okay. So I do have to do it multiple times.
You beat your record, way to go, whatever. You qualify for this bonus prize.
Red rupee. I mean, at least it's paying for itself.
Keep playing and don't leave personal belongings behind. What does it say?
Canon game stand. Okay. I'll do it again. Yeah. Inko. Jesus Christ. Man, my favorite Drew Sun stream is when he played the Canon mini game for a really long time. For just an insanely long time. For just really, really, really long.
You can pay for Canon excellent.
At the Peaceful Bridge ship part. What? Think I'm overstimulated from the music? Alright. Assuming that's what Quack meant by that. That this is just for farming ship points if you don't find them naturally. We'll come back here if we don't find everything. Hey. You have a good floor time. I love you. Oh, wait. Dude was like, talk to the mermaid, do the mermaid quest or whatever the hell. Is there more to do here?
How are you?
Yeah, he's in the map when you're streaming, when you're steaming across the open sea.
Like magic fish out of his little pier. Yeah, whoa, fishing, whoa, go fishing. Hey, catch a big one, show it to me, baby.
They were joking? Okay. Up, up,
up. Oh, you want to get on the ship?
Okay. Well, we can go fishing now. That's something that we've gained the ability to do. We never went this way.
And we're off.
Never went to this island up here. Oh, I see the fish. Look. Chat. Fish. Also island. Oh, this was the blacksmith. I remember. We did this already, but it was because the save stuff happened and, you know, so on and so forth. We'll go there again real quick. We'll make our way there. Yeah. Yeah. We did do this already. Man, it's crazy that in that mini game I only made a profit. I do think that I'm doing the thing where I'm playing the game smart, where I'm trying to like lead my shots and stuff like that, when in reality I shouldn't be doing that. I should be playing this like a baby game for babies and not leading my shots and just clicking on the target. And if it doesn't hit, it doesn't hit. It's not gonna. You know? Yeah, we had this conversation already. Hang on. Can I skip? No. Well. What did he need? There'll come a time when you need my power. Okay. I am reborn. Yeah. I am reborn. You're reborn. I'm Drew. So that happened. Find the stone tiles on the east and west of this island. Connect the eastern stones with a line. Do the same with the western stone. Dig where the extensions of the two lines intersect. Stones? These? Okay. What? There's one right here. Right here. Right here. What is it? It's exact words. Find the stone tiles on the east and west. Connect the eastern stones with a line. Do the same with the western stones. Dig where the extensions of these two lines intersect. Connect the eastern stones with a line. So like this? Do the same with the western stone. The extensions of these two lines? You're right, I can. What is the extensions of these two lines? What does that mean? Like, last time I had to do this, I did, like, a cross, like that. You know? Can I tell you? Last time it was like this. I'll figure it out, Quack. Give me time. Find the stone tiles on the east and west of the island. Connect the eastern stones with the line. Do the same with the western stone. Dig where the extensions of these two lines intersect. Where the extensions intersect. What the fuck does extensions mean in this context? What the fuck is a line's extension? Is this correct? No. extensions. Maybe it's like... like that? Okay, that's a shitty one. It's hard to do with a mouse, okay? Maybe it means that. Yeah, I did. Yeah, I figured it out, Quack. You gotta give me some time. You got a treasure map. Whoa. Gotta do more dredging. This island is nice and warm and laid back. Has to be something hiding in a place like this. Snoop around. Or do you want to leave? I did. I looked around. I mean, I see that there's this here. But I can't get to that yet. Doesn't seem. Oh, yeah. Wait a minute. Maybe I can. Here we go. Mama said there'd be days like this. There'd be days like this. My mama said, mama said, mama said, mama said there'd be days like this. There'd be days like this. My mama said, mama said, mama said. Let's make our way to the fish. Hey God, this requires me to have actual vertical. Hey God, I got this. Give me a second. Hey God, I got this. There you go. Get it, hey God, I got it, I got it, hey God. Okay, never mind, I don't got it. Hey God, I got it, folks. Hey God, I got it. There you go, there you go, yeah, there you go. Okay. We need to make a thing. Hang on. Okay. Hang on. Hang on. We're gonna remedy this. Okay. This has been an issue multiple times. We're gonna fix it now. Hey, Wing. How are you? First off, heck it off. Hang on. We're gonna fix it right now. All right. We're good now.
Okay. So, Splunk, it's your first time fishing. I'll teach you some of the secrets of fishing. Slide the stylus up and down the screen to pull up on your roll. Reel in, make the stylus small. Reel in, make small circles with your stylus.
I don't like this, actually. I think I'm changing my stance. I know I just spent so long. It's a small change. It's small. It's tiny. Hang on. Hang on. It's tiny. Hang on. Hang on, Chad. It's tiny. Tiny, small, little baby change. Hang on. I think I want it like that. So there's, like, a little bit of a bar on the left. And on the right. But it's even? There we go. Yeah, I think that looks better. Okay, now we're good.
To reel in, make small circles with your stylus. When you get a bite, lift up on the rod to set the hook. Timing is key.
Okay. I see.
Hey, you got a bite! The key to fishing is knowing when to pull up on your roll to reel in. If you don't do anything, the gauge at the top screen will drop fast. Make the gauge rise by sliding down on the screen away from the fish. While the gauge is up, reel in the fish by making circles with your stylus. Jump. This one is tricky. When it jumps, take the stylus off the screen and ease up, or it'll go away. Take the stylus off the screen. I see. In other games, that's when you pull. You're like pulling the fish towards you from the air, you know? You caught. How does that make sense? What's going on right here? See that? What the fuck is this? You caught a skippy jack. It measures 2 feet and 0 inches. These fish are common, but they sure are tasty. Check it out. So, once again, the previous video game said that fish don't exist in the ocean. All right, cool. Anyways, I will have to do this every time, though. There's no getting around this. I have lore. Unless it has to do with specifically Wind Waker, I don't want it. Unless it is something that we learned in Wind Waker that I'm forgetting, I don't want it. I can't process what you're saying. If it is something that we learned in Wind Waker that I am forgetting, then I'm down for you to give me lore. If it is something that could be learned in this game or Spirit Tracks, which might be a sequel too, I don't know. And I don't want to know. Is that the Jolene? Okay. It could just be a case of me forgetting something. Salvage. I hope my salvage thing isn't, like, fully broken right now. Okay, cool. I haven't repaired it in a long time. My last day is officially over. What I miss? We learned how to fish, and I made a scene for fishing and other vertical things. Quack is having a bad time because MRI came up with nothing. We did a lot of the target shooting minigame. Finish the mermaid stuff for now. That's what I said. We got the stone chimney ship part. We're gonna head down here and get this fish, and then we're gonna head back up to the horseshoe tree dig. Okay. Pod resumed. I
I think that that was incorrect. I think the VOD hasn't actually been paused. I don't know, though. We caught a fish. We caught a fish and got a stone chimney. Hang on. Hang on. Hang on. Give it. Hang on. Give me a second. Hang on. I gotta change the green layout. I can't make this a hotkey. And then I gotta go over here and do this. Boom. Okay. We're good. All right. Let's game, my gamers. Pull up forever and it just is always positive. Unless the little light goes on. In the opposite direction of the fish horizontally. A Skippy Jack. It's another one. Okay. Same thing that we got before. These fish are common, but they sure are tasty. I wonder what I'm gonna end up doing with any of these. You know what I mean? I wonder what's gonna end up happening with these. Okay. Let's head up to Orshu. A lot of money right now. Let's head to Beetle first, actually. Fish! We had a wisdom gem? Yeah, I didn't buy that. I was looking for a ship part. Vertical. Wait, hang on. Pause. Okay. I'm gonna have to do this every time, but it is what it is. Okay. Okay. Alright, now you can continue. Did Anuma work on this game? My gut says no. Damn, I did. Like, logically, he would have been working on Twilight Princess at this time. Your friendship message confuses and startles me. Scroll up. Keep scrolling. Just scroll through. Look at the animals. You caught a Skippy Jack. It measures to 1 foot with 10 inches. And I keep catching these guys. God damn. Anyways. Merc A. Okay. Hey man. I'm here to customize. So I got a new prow. Tortoise prow. I wonder what's gonna make or break this is if Link stands out here instead of back here. Prow made for those looking for the romance of the sea. Ooh, Titanic. I don't think I have any new anchors. I already have the bright hole equipped. What did the standard hole look like? Okay. Have the fear cannon. We have two separate handrails. We have the wood handrail and the pillar handrail. I feel as though the wood looks better. Very basic handrail. Sometimes the basics are the best. Oh, I'm sorry. You guys should look at this one. Sometimes the basics are the best compared to the standard. Made from pillars of exotic ruins. It was recently recovered. Let's go with the wood. We got a statue on the a castle on the ship. And a rock wheel. A wheel, some say, was made from a giant's dinner plate. Look at our mess of a ship. Everything on our ship is stone chimney. A chimney once used by a bread baker smells fresh baked. Me too. Everything on our ship is now no longer what was originally on our ship, except for the anchor. Stamina is 5. Okay. I wrote a reminder for myself that I needed to go over and look. It is a cop. It is. I needed to dig near Oshu's tree, it said. What? Why does that open this menu? Menu. All other times it would open the item. Did my shit get rebound without me knowing? Alright, I fixed it. Okay. That was weird. Apparently I will. Why May 10th? What's on May 10th? Also, it didn't roll on the stream. At least I didn't hear it. That was weird. Finally nabbed all three spirits, did you? Then weigh anchor. Let's find that ghost ship. Climb aboard. That was weird. I've never seen that. The Friday before my birthday. Why specifically the Friday? Okay, so that led here. We might as well do that first. I didn't remember if you streamed on Sundays. I do. The fish first. Okay. Oh wait, it's okay, you're back now. Hang on. Okay. Thank you. Oh, almost lost it. Oh, I'm losing it! I am pulling! I'm pulling! Okay. Not getting away from me! No. Visibly, this fish does look... I got to pull that way? Why? Am I supposed to pull with the fish's direction, not against? Am I misunderstanding? This fish is different. You caught a tuna. Get it? Because this is Toon Link. So it's tuna. 2 feet, 11 inches. Among the more popular varieties, it's pretty big. Check it on your collection screen. Okay. Okay. Alright, to the north. To the north! Pretty easy. What? That explains why it was easy. I guess I didn't drive close enough to it. I didn't know that that was possible. Because when I'm not close to a fish, see how the fish is, like, not there? I thought that that's what happened with the salvage, but I guess not. I just wasn't close enough. Kind of strange how the chain doesn't activate the mines. I mean, obviously, it would kind of this wouldn't work if it did, you know. But like, very interesting all the same. Okay. You like my penis chimney, Twain? Chimness? Like... me? Like... penis? My chinus? Thanks for the support, I was finally free. Damn it, I was gonna raid you tonight. Hope you had a good stream time, Joe. I'm sorry I wasn't able to raid more. It lined up like... it all lined up like where the bulk of your stream was on my days off. But I wasn't able to raid that much. Plus, I took an extra day off because of a death in the family and so on and so forth. So it was like, you know, it was unfortunate timing of things, but it is. Either as much as you can. I hope you had a good time. I hope you had a good stream. I hope you had fun, and I hope that you continue to have fun since you're never going to quit streaming ever. Subs are double my followers? Damn. You're fine and any level is appreciated. I'm glad. You got the pillar hand. I already have that. Go to the shipyard and... I already have that. I can get duplicates? I can get duplicates of ship parts? Let's not get this fish. Let's go do the thing. I can get duplicates of fish parts? Of ship parts. That makes a lot of things more difficult. Already done. Judy, how are you?
How you doing?
If I meant to fucking follow this path again. Are you doing well? I am. The chat is having a bad day, but well. Huh? What's now? What's going on here? The ship, it's suddenly stuck. Hey, Splunk. Sorry for the unscheduled... Oh, apparently that was y'all talking. Sorry for the unscheduled stop. Something happened down here, and the engine just went nuts. I'm sure that evil ghost ship is the cause. No doubt about it. With that thing around, I guess I'd better get this engine into tip-top shape. Hey, kid. Leave it to me. You've got other things to worry about. You take the helm and, aim at the ghost ship. How? Honestly, how am I supposed to know what? Use your head!
I'll help you find the ghost ship, Splunk! Spirits of Power and Wisdom and I will join up and help find the ghost ship!
Do you have to be so enthusiastic all the time? This is a test of our resolve, Line.
This is the other guy.
Exactly right. I guess it's up to you then. You have to steer, Sploink.
I wish that the game had like little text boxes so that I know who the fuck is talking, you
know? Okay, listen up. I'm gonna do some precise steering here. Here's how this is gonna go. Set the engine to go and make the ship move. Then steer the ship right. That's left and left, of course.
Oh my god. I just almost choked on my spit.
You can touch anywhere on the screen to steer, not just on the wheel. Pay close attention to the spirit's reaction as you turn the ship. Go wild and more directly.
What?
Point it more directly at the ghost ship. Now go!
Okay. Okay, so now I'm off course. I see. Okay, so that little ting is what I'm looking for. There it was. I've seen it for a second.
Finally found the ghost ship. Let's climb aboard.
So, this is the ghost ship everyone is always talking about. It's even scarier than I imagined. And I imagined some scary stuff.
What? Slapback shaking over there? He's such a cuckoo.
Oh, put a crab in it. I just caught a...
Sorry, it's cuckoo. My bad.
Just caught a chill is all. One of those frigid northwest-easter winds. So, yeah, anyway, you just charge on ahead, Sploink. I'll catch up with you as soon as I warm up a little. Meanwhile, try to find your friend Tetra, and make it fast, kid.
Oh, I get it. Linebeck's nothing but a frozen clucking cuckoo. Why don't you wait here shivering? Let's get real comfortable. Maybe you'll lay an egg! A cock!
You shut it, Sparkles! We find treasure, don't expect any share for yourself. You could shovel that treasure into these pockets.
Okay. There's rats on a ghost ship? Oh, the spiders. What are they called? Spulchulas? Boing, the number of treasure chests left here is 2. Let's assume that there's a boss. I'm gonna start the prediction. There's probably a boss at the end of this. I would imagine. I'm obviously intended to go this way. Oh, a ghost fish? Is this game's version of Pose? There we go.
Oh, you! Could you be the legendary Sploink?
Not me!
Don't be silly! You're Sploink, right? I saw right through your little lie.
You knew?
You finally came! I'm the youngest daughter of the great house of Cubis.
Of what?
My sisters were living in peace, and we were suddenly snatched away. We've been locked up on this boat ever since, waiting to be saved. But everything is fine now that you're here to rescue us, Sploink. This is your chance to be a true hero. You save my older sisters? They're locked up somewhere on this ship. There are 4 of us in the Cubis family. I just couldn't bear if I was the only one saved. Please bring my older sisters to me.
No way.
Oh? Am I the only one you are going to rescue because I'm the youngest? My older sisters, please, you must help.
Fine.
Thank you so much. This ship is very dangerous. Most of the abducted have fallen victim to the Reaplings in the hold. Let's say they are fallen. Fallen! They are the fallen! Oh, excuse me, never mind that. I don't know what came over me. I'm so worried about my sisters. Please hurry and rescue them. I wish you luck.
I think she's dead.
I sure didn't think anything could be alive on this ship, Sploink. Thank goodness the Cubis girl.
Oh, sorry, I see.
I sure didn't think anything would be alive on this ship. Thank goodness the Cubis girl was still alive. Tetra locked up somewhere, just like the Cubis sisters. I'm guessing those Reaplings in the hold are scary. But it doesn't matter. We gotta help that girl out. And the older sisters who were locked up here will know where Tetra is.
Yeah, I think they're dead. Spike's going. Oh. Yep, that's the thing that you have the ability to do, apparently. Right? peasy. Okay. In the corner of my eye, I seen the orange of the boomerang popping up of me using the ability, and I jump scared myself. Rude. Oh, do I need a thing to put there? Can I jump that? Oh, I can. Do I need one of those? I now realize what's about to happen. I think I'm gonna have to bring this sister all the way back to the younger sister. I'm doing an escort quest right now. Wait, why am I doing that voice?
Oh, so my younger sister asked you to save me? I see. I'm the third sister of the House of Cubis. Link, will you please take me to where my younger sister is?
Yeah, sure. Come on. Move. Come on. You're no threat. Come on.
Splunk! Oh. I'm so sorry, I was frozen with terror.
I can see why you're locked in here now.
When I'm surprised I get left behind, I start to panic. When that happens, please come close to me and speak to me.
Yeah, I just did. Alright, come here. Oh no! She's stupid! Oh no! She caught the stupid! At least she was out of range of the fire. Come on. Whoops. Oh, and you got stuck because I jumped. Man. What was the name of the fish lady in Ocarina of Time? I liked her more.
Oh, there you are. Oh, there you are, big sis. Oh, there you are, little sister.
I think that's what she said.
I'm so happy that you're okay. Thank you very much, Splink. I'm so very sad that my older sister was not with Tetra after all. Will you please bring back my other two sisters? We'll be hoping for your safe and swift return, Splink.
We'll be eating this candy while we wait. It smirks on our faces.
Huh? You'll be what? Yeah, what's your favorite candy? I guess I need like a circular shard for that. Maybe. Hey, Sassin, thanks for the 8 months.
Oh, hey, 8 months.
Oh, hey. Hope you enjoy your emotes and your billions. How you doing, dog? Oh, is this the Reaplings?
Do you see that? Well, that monster is even scarier looking than anything we've seen before. That's probably one of those Reaplings that Cubis Girl was talking about.
Yeah, probably. How you doing, Assassin? Playing Destiny? I want you, Assassin, only knowing that I will not play Destiny. regardless of what you say. Sell me on Destiny. Not because I want to play it, I just said I won't. But because I want to know what the appeal is. I like peppermint patties. What is a peppermint patty other than peppermint? That's, that part is obvious. Peppermint patty. Oh. Okay. I'm not much of a mint in candy person. Where's my little baby comb? Oh, there it is. Reese's Pieces is an interesting pick. I'm not too big into Reese's Pieces. I'm more of a peanut M&M's kind of person.
Oh, who are you? You see, I'm the second oldest daughter of the House of Cubis. No, I've never heard of anyone named Tetra. But enough about that. Can you escort me back to my younger sister?
Rude, but sure. The only peanuts I like are...
Splinker. Lovely treasure rest here. Yeah, do chess if you must pick one, definitely pick the left. Left. You know which is left, don't you?
No.
I do a funny voice, Splink. Left is the side that isn't right, of course.
I'm gonna pick right. You got the yellow potion. Drink it to restore all your hearts. It will be in your item menu. Well, how about the left now? And Rupor. And to spawn another one.
Oh dear, it looks like I made a little mistake. I'm sorry.
Yeah, so these guys are bad. My instincts are ringing true.
I'm sorry, I'm feeling better now. Let's go.
Boiled peanuts. Very interesting. I had some, what were they? Oh, walnuts. Did I not hit this guy? What were they? Not almonds, not walnuts. Can't remember. I had some, like, nuts that I just, like, went to town on. Very long time. Clearly, since I can't remember the name of it, it's been a long time, and I've never found them again. But other than that, like, I don't know. I try not to snack. I've been failing at that recently. My attempts not to snack on things. Recently, I found poppables, and I've been going to town on those quite a bit. Hi, Yovis, how are you? I've been going to town on those. Oh, I need the fucking... Yeah, you can stay here. I don't care. Good. How's your day going? I'm doing good. Well, I'm doing dandy. I spent my morning writing down jokes. Now here I am. I'm gonna fucking scout ahead to see if there's any more fucking spiders. Goddamn. Doesn't look like it. And then hopefully after stream today, I'll continue writing jokes. I have the energy.
Oh, big sister. There you are, little sister.
I'm so happy that you're okay. Thank you so much, Splink. But it seems as though this sister was not with Tetra either. Can you please bring back my last sister? We'll be hoping for your safe and swift return, Splink.
We'll be waiting for you with bated breath.
Okay. Peanuts, walnuts, coconut shell. I need a key for that. Okay. So their hitbox is on their bulbous head. God, this boomerang's so good. God damn. Steel drum storage ahead. Flip the switch to move the spikes. The switch is on the left and straight ahead. Hurry up. The steel drums are giggling to themselves, waiting for you to free them. We'll do that in a minute. It's just so good. It's like a second sword. Flip the switch to move the spike. The switch is on the left and straight ahead. On the left and straight ahead. Be both on the left and also. I guess northwest? Novus, what's your favorite candy? Mine is Heath bars. Me fooled. Can't see nothing. Some things in this world were meant to be pulled. 2, 4, 5, 1, 3. Okay, hang on. While we listen to this banger. 2, 4, 5, 1. There's always an order in which things, such things should be pulled. Right now it's payday, can't get enough of it. Those are good. Two, 4. Oh. I think I realize how I messed up. 5. 1. It's not pull in this order. It's this one is 1, this one is 2. It's not. Wait, no. Okay. 1. 2. 3. 4. 5. Killed the spider. I'm glad that didn't consistently spawn more of these Reaper dudes. Oh, holy shit. Stuff to me. Oh shit. Is this guy about to come murder me? Am I about to get murderized? Yes, I am. Yeah, what are you gonna do now? Oh shit. Okay. Yeah, what are you gonna do now, loser? A very sudden, out of nowhere urge to play D&D. It came out of nowhere. I haven't felt that for like months, maybe a month at this point. And nothing brought that on. There is nothing that happened that was like D&D. That was weird. Sign? What's a sign? I didn't know you played D&D? I do. Or have, I guess. I haven't played for a while. DM too. Haven't done that for a while. Haven't done that way longer than that of which I've played. How do I get past this guy? Did he ever turn down? What? I don't remember the song. What if I just come out of here? Nice. Purple potion, drink it to restore 8 hearts. Oh, nice. What the fuck is that? Oh, the barrel. You have the urge to play D&D. Gotcha. Look, I don't make the rules. You have to stop everything and make a D&D character right now for your next campaign. I already have multiple. At first, I thought you said League? No. Valorant? Yeah, every now and then. Mostly right now, most of my urges are Helldivers 2 right now.
Oh, you found me. I was getting lonely sitting here by myself. Who are you? I see. Well, I'm the eldest sister of House Cubis. Please take me to my younger sister, Sloik. Oh, there is one thing I have to tell you. The creepy creatures with the hoods and sickles are called Riplings. They are evil. But they are even more devilish when they're angry. So no matter what you do, don't shoot arrows into their backs. The back is essentially a part of the body, you know.
Huh. Oh, that makes sense. The fucking, the night dudes did have arrows. Or eyeballs in their backs. Thank you. how long they stay stunned. Pretty long. Come on. Guy's on his way. The only thing League is good for is the bops of songs they release with artists. I wouldn't say it's just the songs. I'd say it's the art too. League has very good art. Unfortunately, they don't really utilize that for the game itself. It's really just kind of like the player card things that pop up and then the music video stuff. It's like League of Legends has like Overwatch syndrome, where it's like the animations that they make are like the highest absolute peak of quality, to the degree where they should just make a show or movie, but they refuse to and just continue making a shitty game. You know? That being said, I am looking forward to Marvel Rivals quite a bit. Not to the degree where I'm like, oh my god, I'm so excited, but like, I am looking forward to it. I'm hoping that it's good. I do like the gameplay of Overwatch too. It's just all the microtransactions, the monetization. I feel the same way about Valorant. Like I like Valorant a lot. I really, really do. But the monetization strategy is ridiculous. If Valorant wasn't on Game Pass, where I got all the operators for free, because I had, well, you know, free because I have Game Pass, I wouldn't play it.
Oh, big sister.
There you are, little sister.
Circle around the sister. Circle around, sisters. Time for some quality family time. Reaping should... I should have scared...
What?
Reaping should have scared the life from this boy in the hold. Doesn't he know he's supposed to play along in this little game? Hee-hee. All it means is we're gonna have to play extra rough. Why did you come here to save Tetra, little man? Oh, no, no. Instead, we'll play with you the same we played with her.
It's a game time, girls. Let's show Splink the way to the playing field.
What? The sisters are bad?
If you want to save Tetra, you'll have to play a match of Dead Man's Volley first. So are you a big enough boy to return these volleys?
Unfortunately, can't use the bottle this time. Alright, hang on. This is one of those cases where this is a vertical situation. Give me a second. Boom. Boom. Then, boom. There you go. Okay. Now you can see vertically. That's volley. I'm not even looking. I already know what to do. There's one sister down. Oh wow. Oh god. That was cool as shit. Whoa! That was super cool. I will say, the boat stuff in this game is not that great. I think that that's definitely the weak point of the game so far. Every boss fight has been cool. So far. I think the weakest one was the second one. Honestly, because I can't even remember what it was. I only remember the tornado octopus. And now this one. I think there was one other one. I can't remember what it was. I'm pretty sure the... sure the octopus was the Isle of Gust, and then there was also the Power Island. I don't remember what it was. One where you could see yourself in the boss's view. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that one was definitely the worst of the three so far, but it was still cool. It was a cool idea. I don't think it was executed the best.
Spoink.
Oh shit, hang on. My bad. Hang on. Wait. Okay.
You really know how to play, Spoink. Gosh. We'd love to reward you, but we don't have any trophies for you. Instead, you can drag that precious treasure of yours with you. Goodbye!
Try too. I forgot this is a sequel to Wind Waker, and I was like, Tetra? Yeah, this is a sequel to Wind Waker. I don't know, don't confirm or deny. Spirit Tracks might be one too. But this is a direct sequel to Wind Waker, yeah. Also, welcome back, Quack. I hope you're feeling better, at least a little. You got the ghost key.
That was amazing, Spoink! Those wicked folly girls at their own game. Come on, let's go use this key and rescue Tetra.
There's a lesson here, chat. Don't trust a person that plays volleyball. You got a heart container. You increase your life by one. Volleyball in high school? What the frick? I'm glad that you've grown since that time. I'm glad that you've grown and advanced and become a better person since that time. Thank you. My dad was like, can I give you my brain after he understood what was going on?
What?
Can I give you my brain? That's adorable. Dad is adorable. Oh, I thought that was the ghost door. I was confused. Is it on top floor? No, it's here. Okay. I was confused. I thought it was that way. Love me, Dad. I love your dad, too.
Sorry I'm late, kid. That fog just disappeared, so I charged in to find you. So about that treasure, you got piles of it, right? What?
Oh, how can you even say that? Well, his friend is in trouble, and all you can think about is treasure!
Oh, is this your friend? He's looking a bit pale. Oh, something isn't right with this girl. Her soul didn't get sucked, did it? This evil ship drained away her life force.
Grandpa, what are you doing here?
We've come this far, Sproink. The power of the hero is with you. Now it is the time for me to tell you the rest of the story. You're a clever boy. They already know this. You see, these seas are my domain. I'm not Oshish. I'm the ocean. I was savagely attacked by an unfathomable evil. His name is Bella. His evil ran so deep that it unleashed the very life. As you know, every creature in this world possesses a sacred power. This power is called life. The sand of ours is a physical manifestation of that power. And that is what brought them. I struggled against my attacker in a great clash. But his evil was so dark that it slowly drained away my own life. He was always a step ahead of my attacks, and I was eventually I was dragged to the sunless depths of the temple. Sealed up, my life force continues to fade away. Using the life force he leached from me, evil spread and bred more and more foul monsters. The spirit of power and wisdom are also imprisoned. Ciela managed to split her soul and escape. That split was why so much of her memory was lost. Even among the monsters born of the sand of ours, some are especially evil. The phantoms who roam the temple take after the evil of their master. Supernatural strength wrapped in plate armor. Virtually invincible. They prowl the temple, searching for victims. No one can harm them. Of course, they were created to be untouchable. I had only one option. My ocean of strength had drained to just a puddle. Using my last ounce of strength, I cloned myself just as Ciela did, and then made a humble home on Mercury Island. I used the sand of hours to make the hourglass and enter the temple. I studied my foe, searching for ways to defeat Vellum, and waited for my chance. Ciela, I'm sorry. I'm worried. I worried about the spirits of power and wisdom. I never expected to find you on the beach. You lost your memory. The monsters were nearby. I thought it best to keep quiet until the time came. These islands are rich in life force. Evil things must have appeared to devour that. They just want to fill their empty bellies. They hunger for life force. Ghost Ship was made to drain that life force. They used a story, treasure to lure people in. Probably. It wasn't enough for Vellum to steal my life force. He had to take that little.
I didn't touch it.
Tetra must have had a bold, vibrant soul. Ghost Ship was drawn to that power. She didn't find it. It found her.
Wait, so you're telling me there's no treasure?
Yes, that's what I'm saying. What I can sense, Tetra is still alive. Defeat that monster before my life force is depleted. Must get the sand of ours. With it, I can return Tetra's life force and restore. There is an island north of the Isle of Gus. Go there and find Zaus. He's a blacksmith. He will tell you more about the great people. He knows how to slay Vellum.
This is some kind of sick joke, old man. The treasure? What about all the treasure? That was the only reason I put my life on the line. And now there's no treasure. Will I quit?
You quit? You didn't even listen to a story? You're a man of the sea. Don't you want to help the ocean, kid?
No, and you can't use my ship anymore. No.
No.
I would never ask you to do this for free. If you help us defeat Vellum, I will grant you one wish. What do you say to that?
Hey, quit standing around, kid! The Ocean King is in trouble! Ship out, kid! Anchors away! I said move it!
One word about a wish, he leaped into action!
I'm sorry, sir. I'm so sorry. You shouldn't have involved you and Tetra in this, With your power, you can defeat Vellum. A real body is sealed away, deep in the temple. Vellum should be there, too. Normally, I would be fighting this battle myself, but I only hope. We're counting on you.
What are you doing, Sploink? Grab that friend of yours and get back to my ship! Alright, Sploink. We've got to get out of here.
There's no time to sit around with your mouth hanging open. The old man said Zaus, the blacksmith, holds the clue to that we're looking for. We had to find that blacksmith and defeat Bellum. And then...
And then the treasure will be in my hands.
What's wrong with you? Hey, we really need to take this guy with us, Blink.
Anyway, let's get going.
House lives on the island to the north of the Isle of Ghost, right? That'd be a short trip from here.
Yep, let's stop wasting time. Let's go ship out.
I want to point out that I actively changed the old man's voice to be more seaman in the middle of that to show him like uncovering himself, and you know, I'm gonna need a little bit of praise, you know, I'm gonna need a little bit of voice acting praise. Okay, I actively changed his voice in the middle of dialogue. Okay, I'm gonna need a little praise. I'm gonna need a little praise, you know. Man, we found Zao, refound Zao, I guess. Zaus. And he was, like, immediately used. You know? They were like, hey, there's this Zao's blacksmith guy. And I was like, oh, I know all about him. We just left there. Yeah. We'll meet up with him. What's this? Huh? I don't know. We just seen him, but I forgot what voice I gave him.
Oh, I knew you'd be visiting soon.
Zaus! So you know Grandpa? How do you know him?
You see, for generations, our ancestors lived to serve the Ocean King. They defended the Ocean King in an age when great evil lurked in the sea. My people forged their own weapons and fought in epic battles. You see, one of those great weapons, an artifact called a Phantom Sword.
So, we need that sword to defeat Bellum like Grandpa told us?
That's right. Bellum has the power to drink the life force from you. The Phantom Sword can slay him. Now you must find the Phantom Sword and defeat him.
Okay, let's get Bellum's point. His house. Can you let us borrow that Phantom Sword?
I no longer have it.
What? No?
No, I do not.
You've got to be kidding. Well, why tell us how we should defeat Bellum when it's pretty much impossible?
Don't jump to conclusions. I'm Zaus, the blacksmith. I may not have one now, but I can make one.
Oh, you can? Okay. Well, what are you waiting for? Make one.
I can't.
Can't? What do you mean you can't make one for us? Are you joking?
The Phantom Sword is no ordinary sword. When forged, normal metal can never handle that kind of sacred power. Aquanine, Azurine, and Crimsonine. These three pure metals must be forged together to create the Phantom Sword.
Well, come on, Sprite! Let's find those three pure metals! Well, where can we find them?
Long ago, the Ocean King gifted the pure metals to three tribes in this world. The three tribes must have passed these treasures down over generations. Visit those tribes and they should be able to tell you the location of those metals.
Oh my god, I need a break. Hang on, holy shit. Ugh.
Okay.
Mystery traps, but where are we supposed to go?
Going to fuck it. Ooh, you're gonna get circumcised, croissant. Ooh, you're gonna get circumcised. You're gonna get circumcised. It's gonna happen. Gonna happen, croissant. You keep it up. You keep up this behavior. Circumcised. Gonna happen.
I traveled a lot, but I never met someone who'd have a pure metal.
Must go in search of sea charts. You will need more sea charts in addition to the ones you already have. Enter the Temple of the Ocean King and get the next sea chart.
We've already got to the bottom of the Temple of the Ocean King. There weren't any other paths we could have taken.
There was a door that you could open by drawing a symbol, was it not? Was there not? You draw this symbol on that door, another way should open.
Wow, who knew that door had such an amazing secret? Make note of that symbol and let's go to the temple, Spoink.
Good luck out there, Spoink.
So, like, I'm actually suffocating myself. So these two voices take place in two completely different places of my body. Like, entirely different places. So while I'm doing these two voices, I have to take my voice and change the location of where my voice is coming from actively. And they just kept going back and forth and back and forth. I could do that for a short period. That was not a short period. I was legitimately suffocating myself doing that. There was a moment when I was like, I need to take a break. I legitimately felt like I was gonna pass out. I still kind of do a little bit. Like, that was a lot. You should learn techniques. You don't want brain damage. I was doing the techniques. It's just because I was doing them for so long. I needed a break. Okay, well, it won't let me, like, I mean, like, I don't really need to write it down. It's just from the top, start down. Okay. Not proper technique. I don't care. It's a technique I know. Oh my god. In reality, it happens so rarely. You're getting brain damage? No, I'm not. It's fine. You're conflating, okay? I'm not getting brain damage. It's fine. It happens so rarely where I have to take the high-pitched voice and transition over to the low-pitched voice. Like, that doesn't happen at all. You're literally convulsing right now? I'm literally not. Like, that happens so rarely. Like, I can do the high-pitched voice forever. I can do the low-pitched voice forever. Swapping back and forth? Oh my god. And that happens so rarely. Like, it's only happened twice. That is the second time it's ever happened. I think the other time that's happened was, there was a cutscene in Skyward Sword where I think it was Impa and Zelda talking back and forth for a really long time. I think that's what it was. I might be wrong. But there was a voice in that where it was like, oh my god. I just kept going back and forth. It was, oh my god, that was rough. If you want to see a cool video, Will Ramos, I don't know who that is, and it had Dr. Ingo Titsy put a camera up his nose, down his throat to see what the throat and epiglottis does when people do heavy vocals, like screaming goblin noises. But you're fine. You don't need to apologize for that. I like it. I don't know who either of those people are, though. Oh, yeah.
So you found a way to defeat the monsters, but, Hello, right? Sword? Pure metal? Why is it that every time we... it's fine. I'll follow you until the end, but, like, you know, hurry up. And then you'll defeat Bellum. Got that? Okay? All right. Well, then. We gotta set sail. All aboard. We're aboard. We're off to the sea.
You wake up. You've been in a coma for years. my job. Crack over here trying to mansplain to me. That's my job. What the fuck was the symbol for the Southern Sea? Key chart. An X, but like with the bottom. Bottom X. On my period, I'm correct. That's not how that works. Phil Ramos is the lead singer of Lorna Shore. I don't know what that is. And Dr. Ingo Titsy is the lead scientist in throat design slash health. That's cool. Oh my god. Delivery! Here's a letter from Lineback. The guy who kind of started the there are techniques you should do so you can make sounds and not ruin your throat forever. Okay. You can DM me the video if you want on Discord. This is a letter from Lineback. here goes. From Lineback T. Splunk. This is weird. Why am I writing to you when we're together all the time? But just give me a moment to remember why I was writing to you. Oh, so I'm writing because, well, I'm grateful. All right. Happy now? Okay, thanks. There, I've said it. Well, this is awkward. What's next? How about, thanks for working like a dog for me, you treasure dog. See, that's something you just can't say to a guy's face, you know? One more thing, a gift to show my thanks. Keep it to yourself or else. This is the third pillar handrail I've gotten. And that's the end of it. Got all that, sir? Then I'm out of here. I really like the idea, and I made a good pick on this, a good choice. I really like the idea of a mailman that reads your mail to you, but he's really bad at reading. Like, his reading comprehension is rough. So he just reads really, really slowly and badly. Like, there is a times one, so I can get duplicates of ship parts. That fucking sucks. That really fucking sucks. That's really bad. So there's going to be a point where I'm gonna have one part that I don't have, and I'm gonna have to grind to find it. That fucking sucks. I hate that. That is the worst. That is the worst. That is horrendous. What a horrible choice that is. Hey, Blackjack, how you doing? This is the raid. How you doing? Guys, I've had these off. So a lot of things just popped. Hey, Dreamer, how you doing? Anyways, someone shout out Blackjack real quick. Nice choice. Not sure what it is, but look at that color. For you, 500 rupees. It is a power gem. Gets me upgrades later. Which I might have access to right now. How much is this? 240. Nah. I don't know what they're used for yet. How many of those do I got? 9? I needed 10, I believe.
There. Sorry for being so loud. I thought you were going to walk right on by, so I got a little too excited. Anyway, have you heard about the Chief of Frogs?
No.
You're likely to encounter many many golden frogs, but one of them reigns supreme, a giant golden frog that rides on the winds. I do believe he's been spotted here. Oh, see, he's all measuring, ba 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 ba. Hey, have you heard about Chief of Frogs?
Yes.
So you know, are you paused? Alright, bye.
There's an earthquake.
Another earthquake? I can sense it! Coming from the temple deep beneath! So, Ella must be causing earthquakes to keep rattling the island. Hurry! Get that sea tree and find the pure metals!
Okay, let's get in the temple. I believe we gotta redo some stuff in this temple in order to make our way to the end. We don't really have that many new items in comparison to what we had. I thought it looped around. Are falling apart. Now I know that I can shoot him in the back.
That one is red! That's a phantom red!
Personally, I don't see color Ciela.
It looks more powerful than the ones we had to face before!
That evil monster is a swift phantom. As you might guess, they're much faster than your other phantoms.
Oh, great!
Even if they are fast. It doesn't matter as long as they don't see you, right?
He's right! Oh, be extra careful and sneaky, Spoink!
I didn't know the fairies had gender. I like how Ciela chooses to talk to you outside of the safe zone. Yeah, that's crazy. Love this 2 second loop. By far, out of everything that I feel this game does wrong, the only one that actually super bothers me on the grand scale is the music. Like, honestly, the boat stuff not being great, not that big of a deal. Stuff not being great, not that big of a deal. There are like good bits and pieces in it. I think I need to like hit a gem or something. Get that going, right? Not a gem, but yeah, this. Orb. Maybe I'm misremembering. Where the fuck do I get this key? Oh, I remember. I get it from this guy. He has it on his back. No, I'm wrong. Well, shit. Yeah. I remember when I lost my mind. It's been canceled now. Yeah, I liked Midna and Fee. Navi was okay. Okay, I'm only mostly dying. Man, how did I drop? Help! Oh, this is different. I'm gonna drink a potion. Accept backseating here because this is just simply me not remembering something. Can you do it? Oh, I guess I've already done it. Can you crawl into the hole? No. I haven't gained the ability to crawl yet. I don't have access to my knees right now. Fuck it, rebound my controls again. What the hell? Why? Weird. Can't just like get in here, right? No. Well, I know the key ends up in there, but I don't remember how to make it crawl in there.
Thank you.
Got it. In the lever cronk, I did pull it. I just needed to push both of those things. And I just didn't remember that I needed to push, that I needed to hit both of the gems. I legitimately lost 3 minutes of time because I didn't remember something that I did ages ago. The game is like, the reason this temple sucks is because it's fucking 20 years since the last time that I did it. This was like 4 temples ago and it's expecting me to remember things. Only reason. Temple itself is so far fine. But it is entirely based on me remembering things. Nothing feels more like liberty and freedom than calling an eagle strike on your own team. Oh, hell yeah. Didn't know this game existed until you started playing it on stream, Drew. I love it so much. It is a legitimate 10 out of 10 video game for me. Yeah, but you probably played it a lot closer together, Quack. There's days in between me playing this game. You probably played it Tuesday, and then you were like, Wednesday, I gotta play more of that game, you know, I'm gonna play it when I wake up in the morning, and then you play this more, and then you woke up in the morning again, and you played it again. And, you know. Shot and I missed, and I lied down, and I missed again. There's an alternate reality where I give up streaming every single game and become a Helldiver streamer exclusively. We're not living in that reality. boy, do I wish I was. Helldiver view. That's what that would be, yeah. That's why we're not living in that reality. Because the second that I switch over to playing any other game, they would all leave. Is there wrong with those viewers? No. second that I start playing any other game, they would leave. That's the problem with niching down. When you niche down, you have to stay in that niche or you get punished. Here's a pee break. Oh, hello, Gaiman. Hello. Hello, Gaiman. Gaiman, hello? Boom. Whack. I missed. Whack. Okay. There might be some time up here, actually. I think there was last time. There we go. 30 seconds. His name is Bellum, and honestly, he sounds like a bell end. That's some Animal Crossing fishing ass joke. Right there, that's what that was. That was at least a sequel. Oopsie. Sarah Bellum's evil cousin? I don't know who that is. This joke was not made for me. Bellum as in brain? Lady from the Powerpuff Girls? Oh, I didn't, well, here's the thing, when I was a little babu child, you can keep in mind, that I didn't grow up in no California or nothing. I grew up in, the Republican red state of Indiana. Powerpuff Girls is a girl show. That I did not watch. Okay, I'm just gonna go. I can't get through there. Also in Proud Family, never watched that. I believe I was too old for Proud Family by the time that came out. Could be wrong. But I didn't watch it. Hey, Beale, good morning. How are you? I like that emote. Very cute, very cute. In a household of that. Couldn't hit him. Also, with two kids and one cable TV, so I watch boy shows and my brother watch girl shows. It is what it is. I grew up mostly alone. I grew up with a brother who's a sociopath, and I was not able to stand up for myself, so I did what he wanted to keep the peace. I don't know. Wanted to watch Powerpuff Girls. I think my first like girl show that I watched was probably obviously girl shows in quotes. I can't think of my probably Jenny Was a Teenage Robot or whatever that Jenny the Teenage Robot rather. I think that was probably the first thing. I didn't, like, religiously watch it, though. I just seen the episode here and there, though. What else? Lower game audio, please. Yes, this was a very long time ago. One moment. It doesn't look like the game is that much louder than me or anything at most points, though. But I have made my my audio ducking more aggressive. Hi, Lou. Just a little bit. Man, there sure are a lot of drawings on this one. Like it's your problem that nobody else in your chat is a whiny bitch like me. Yeah, I guess. I didn't read what she said because 90% of what she says has zero value to me. In a single stroke, draw the sacred crest to reveal a new path. Baby game for babies. This is what I'm doing right now. I did it twice. Run out of ink? I didn't say what am I doing wrong, did I? Thank you.
what I'm doing. Figuring it out. It showing me the crest that I need to draw doesn't help me learn the order in which I draw it, you know what I mean? I've run out of ink. Oh, that counted? Okay, apparently that counted. It says that I, like, run out of ink and it doesn't let me finish, but apparently that counts. Said, I am doing this wrong. Okay, well, I didn't ask. I knew what symbol I needed to draw. I just needed to learn how to draw it. Also, hi, T, and hello, Thunder. How are both of you?
This room looks different than it did last time. Maybe we went to another place when we used the quest that Zal showed us. Hey, Splink! It's my turn now. This is the door of courage. Only the power of courage can open it.
I was just being a sasspot. I'm gonna fucking circumcise you next. Get your courage to tap it.
Hey. Dark terrors lurk ahead. I'll share something with you that will help you survive. Step into the yellow light to save your journey time and return to the entrance. Step into the yellow light at the temple entrance to return here. In other words, this is a midway point.
Yeah, I get it.
Go on, give it a try.
No.
Nya!
Save point. Hey, speaking of save point.
Boop, boop.
I'm much... I wasn't looking. It took you this long to reach this room. Want to return to the temple? No. Much better with a night off and the paycheck I was supposed to get a week ago. I'm glad you got your money. Money. But also that means 3 minutes you lost at the beginning will follow you every run. I don't care. Gamer.
Miss Blunt, did you hear something?
This floor makes a sound when you run on it. The
phantoms, they'll hear us.
But the floor didn't make a sound when you walk.
I get it. You have to walk slowly on these floors when there's a phantom nearby.
I don't care.
Boing, 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 boing.
This might head up over here. Hi. I need a round orb for this. I did not want to pull out. I didn't want to pull out. I chose not to. Uh-oh, you're pregnant now. Uh-oh, oops. Oopsie poopsie.
I found the O pedestal, but where is the O crystal? I should have made a note.
Oopsie poopsie. Oh.
Oh, oh, oh. It's magic. You know. Never believe it's not so. It's magic.
Is that dude walking on nothing right now? I wonder if I can do that.
right here. Oh yeah, looky there. Where does this go?
I will teach you something valuable for stopping by. Use that device you had to take aim at the phantoms from behind. Even if they are invincible, it should have an effect.
I didn't exactly absorb what he just said to me. What did he say? What was that? Yeah, that's fair. Yeah, I didn't need that time. You're fucking with me. Bounces on my pussy. I love the way he rides. Can hardly breathe when he's pumping deep inside. Kisses on my neck and then I kiss up on his pussy. Same exact thing happened. I didn't need that time anyways.
Strange, I can't find the key. It would be so easy if I could just bring it down from the floor above.
Okay, so I need to go a floor up. Nice. You like this 3-second loop of music? Good shit. What's worse, this or the Wind Waker sailing music? This. Wind Waker sailing music was still good, it was just repetitive. This is both bad and repetitive. Because I really thought that the controls were to be like my main complaint of the game. I really thought that that would be like the point of contention, but like,
it looks like this was the last floor, but let's keep going.
Thanks for saying literally nothing of value. It's crazy because, like, I thought that. I thought that, that the main point of contention, the main issue that people had with this game, and that I would have with this game, was going to be the controls. But, like, in reality, they haven't been that bad. Like, it hasn't really been that rough. Hang on. I see what I have to do.
I know what I have to do, I just don't know if I have the will to do it.
Well, that wasn't the answer. Alright. I don't even remember what I said, Quack. Time is for losers. I thought I could get up there in time. Yeah! Well, what even is the point of being up here?
Tier 100, hello, Drusun. I think you should try just getting past this part, ha 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 ha. I am both funny and original, ha ha.
Yeah, it was pretty original and funny. Thank you for the 100 bits, Sailor. I'll try that. I don't need to go up, I need to go down. I thought I would just be able to drop down onto where the thing is, but apparently not. How you doing, Sailor? Hope I am more audible. I've been making an effort to speak up. I was hoping the block would stop the arrows, and it just really didn't. It just really didn't do anything. It did, like, less than nothing, you know? Oh. Well, this isn't what I need. Oops! I'm glad that got flung back up. I was about to be upset. Yeah, I don't know. So, this is the key spot, right? This spot right here is where the key is, or where I need the key. Right.
was blocked off. There's a hole in your head? Why does that keep happening? I need to change my lighting stuff. Not for right now. That leads right here. Can I get over this way? I can. Is this a wall or is this an elevation? It looks like an elevation. I'm gonna bomb it in. Don't hit me. Thank you. Okay. What's over this way? A bomb. And that is for this. I have 34 seconds. Can you imagine if that worked out? I can't believe that worked. I actually really like the low health beeping sound in this game, because it's always in rhythm to the music. Yeah, it's always in rhythm to the insanely repetitive beat.
Hey, I felt something behind me, but I turned around and nothing was there. Next thing I knew, the sand of the hourglass was powerless.
I don't think he's talking about the phantoms. Is there something else around here? Careful, Spoink.
No.
Seconds, let's go! No time! Okay. Got this. Just gonna require some patience. I got this. Okay, I'm gonna run over here, and I'm gonna wait. Didn't work out. It did not work out. Repeat, mission failed. We'll get him next round. Me with mermaid that's not a mermaid, huh? 12 seconds in a dream. 8, 7, 6. Come on, man. Ooh. on. Oh, now I need all the gems. We got this. Dropped. Just double checking. Time. Okay, we got 26 seconds. Wisdom gem. Now and then I got a little bit phantom night turn around. I'm a lyrical genius. Hey, you're going the wrong way. Hey, wait a minute. Hey, come back. Hey, come back here. Come back now, you hear? Make any sound, Bucko? I don't know what you're talking about. Oh. Got him. You got the elegant chimney part.
Oh boy.
Okay. Easy peasy. Oh shit, he's right there. Okay. Easy peasy. Wait, that makes that go away? But I need, but. Curse you 100%ing! Okay, check this out. Walk off. I should spawn back up there.
Oh, yes!
Shit. Mistakes can be made, basically. Drink the potion. This is our absolute last shot. This is all we got. Our final hurrah. Okay. this door closes when I pick up that gem. Oh, I guess I'd have to walk all the way back around. Okay, I know what I have to do. It's not here. No. One heart. One heart. This is all I got. I think there might be chests right here. Or not chests, but stars. There isn't. I'm a gamer. Why is that wall there? Oh, it kind of works, actually. Hang on. Okay. Boy in green, I've seen you a lot lately. The skeletons you see here were not prepared to enter this cursed place, but they know now. Get good, loser.
If you died next to a homie,
legitimately, doing that with zero time might have been the most fun I've had this entire video game. Do I have to redo all of that, or are the gems just there? Out. Do I need to re-get those gems, or are they just there? I think they're just there. I think I just have to go back. That's super forgiving. Once again, the baby game for baby. Okay. I went the wrong way. Oh, but the air's not on. Nailing it. Okay.
is so unfortunate. It did fully reset, rather. Okay. No, it fully reset. I have to go get them again.
Okay.
Now we know. And now we pause. I got through the door. Set the crystals on the pedestal in this order. Square, circle, triangle. Going down the exit is the way. This is your favorite Zelda game? Dubbo? Or are you goofing? Ever plan on playing any of the Persona games? Persona 5 and 4 interest me, 3 doesn't, honestly. Maybe down the line, but, I don't know, they're not off the table, but it's not, not something that would be soon, at the very least. I do not have plans to do it. You got a new sea,
got a new sea chart! Now we can explore even more of the sea! Okay, Splink, where do you want to go now? Want to try where that fallen explorer mentioned? You have enough time?
Yeah. Okay. I lied, it's actually spirit tracks? Really? It's square, circle, triangle, I believe is what it said. Did I read that wrong? Did I misremember? I might have misremembered.
Looks like something moved outside. There was a huge tremor. Like the whole floor sank down.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, this isn't the same place we came at last time. The tunnel goes on and on. How many floors are in this place anyways?
So, you're saying that your favorite Zelda game is Spirit Tracks, but you also love this game too? Interesting. It's usually the opposite. Most people don't like this game. There are more phantoms. They're not like any we've seen.
There's more phantoms. They're not like any we've seen before. Just stay sneaky like always, Splunk.
Okay. Can't get there. Hi.
Will not get away.
I will. Actually benefits me? Oh, never mind. Bye! Never finished Phantom Hourglass? I should do. You give it a shot? I've been having a good time with it. Other than the repetitive music and the overworld stuff that isn't grand, I have been having a good time with it. I do think that it is underrated. Never mind.
shoot him? How can I hit him?
It wouldn't let me dig. It wouldn't let me dig. I could. I had it out. It wouldn't let me. It wouldn't let me dig. I tried so hard to dig. It wouldn't let me dig. Okay, I'll go left this time. That's a nice sound. So far, the only real complaint I have about this game. Okay, that didn't work. Try again. So far, the only real complaint I have about this game. Is that the music is like 3 seconds long and it's a repetitive clip every single time. Some of the music in the game that is like during cutscenes and stuff, very nice. Most of it is a 3 second loop. And it is very bad. Which you're hearing right now. My only real complaint of the game. The controls are a little, like, rough. Definitely difficult to get used to at the very least. I would have preferred if this game didn't utilize the stylus so much. I would have liked to at least a little bit of something on the controllers, you know? But it's not horrible. It's not the worst thing in the world. Definitely not. I think. I didn't want that. Looks like I need a, you know, that wasn't really well thought out. Looks like I need a, hook shot. I think I need the hook shot to get through this. I think I'm supposed to leave. Or at least a hookshot equivalent. I think it's intending me to go explore the Southern Sea to get the item that I need to move on. Which is fine. Got new ship parts. Do I remember what? No. No, I don't. But I know we got new ones. Okay. We have a shell wheel. Elegant chimney, that's what it was. A simple shape, but something about it is so enticing. Don't I have something else that's elegant? Thought I did. I don't remember what. I have the bright hole. Does that count as elegant? They're in the same category. I just want to see if that raises my stamina. Maybe it didn't. Bright hole is part of that set, I think. So, does it go up now that I'm using two of the same set? Or is it only if I have all of the same set? This is a real coprophilia. This is a real question. Stone chimney and these two things go together. These two things go together. So if anything, that should already be happening. If that is the case of, like, having two of the same thing equals more stamina, I should have, I think, five now. So either way, it wouldn't make a difference if I had the bright hole in the elegant or the stone in the thing that I currently have, the, whatever. Hey, Whimsy, I love you. Mwah. Be a bit of fun, the sea chart? Perfect. I bet somewhere among these islands are pure metals we seek. Let's take on the waves, Sploink. Climb aboard. The open sea calls. The ship has three or four parts of the same set. The ship's stamina increases to four hearts. Five or six of the same set, five. Okay, well, currently I have five. I wasn't looking. But I think I only have two of the same set, unless this is all, the wheel is also part of that set and I don't realize. Which is possible. What the fuck is that? Like a big pirate ship? Like a fast boy? The ability to hate. I hate that I don't get anything for doing that. Maybe I do. Maybe there's something at the bottom now that they died. I doubt it. But it's possible. Nada. Nothing. I changed my mind. I'm gonna leave the VOD unpaused for this segment, because this is a new C. Yeah, this is a new ocean, so it makes sense to leave it unpaused so that VOD watchers can see the new stuff. I hate that Link doesn't stand on the edge of this.
Wow, what in the world is this? Whoa, that was crazy. Who did that cyclone think it was anyways? Engine is soaked. We're stuck. Ugh, hang on. Something feel odd to you? Ah! Look, kid!
Very quick redemption, prediction.
What is that disgusting thing? And at a time like this, this day couldn't get any worse! Okay, but we need to face up to it, Splunk. That monster, no, a monster like that, who knows how to deal with it? Maybe. Oh! Fire! Fire! Fire some more, yes! As long as you keep shooting, we just might survive this. Oh man, the machinery, you just aim and fire.
the whale from Skyward Sword. We're killing it. What'd you say?
Staying alive. Staying alive.
Kind of reminds me of an octopus. Low-key, a really creative design, and I wish Subnautica had designs like this more often. Easiest game I played in my life, dog.
Wow, how do we do that? We sent it to the bottom of the sea, Sploink. And hey, the engine's had a chance to dry out, so let's set our course. Let's go.
Oh look, it's Jolene.
Jolene, 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 Jolene.
Dolly Parton slowed down is like one of my favorite things.
Hey, look at the map! Our houses! I wonder if there's a pure metal here.
Amateur. Places like this always have treasure stowed away somewhere.
Fine. Fine then. You supposedly have a nose for this, so we'll follow your instincts.
Can't say if it's pure metal, Wolfide, but whatever. We'll scare up, it's all mine. I'm chewing on Oshu's, the Ocean King's office, Bloink. I'll grant any wish that I whip up, but what would you wish for, I'm curious? Treasure, right? Or maybe you'd wish for three more wishes.
Come on, Beck! You don't understand Bloink at all, do you? He's doing this for Tetra, for the Ocean King, and to bring peace to the seas!
You're sort of a good guy, Sploink. Wow, that was out of character for me, wasn't it? Ugh. Go then. Get out of my sight and fetch me some pure metal.
Well, that was weird. Rindbeck must have eaten something funny. Whatever, Sploink. Let's go look at that pure metal.
Will we find the pure metal? Will we craft the sword? Will we get to the bottom of that one area that I messed up? Hang on. Will we get to the bottom of that one place that we were just in? Find out next time on Phantom Hourglass.